الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترضيه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له الحمد لله الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد البر الرحيم الحمد لله الذي خلق كل شيء وقدره تقديرا الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق إلى أمة أمية جاهلة فأخرجها من ظلمات الجهل والجاهلية وعلمها وجعلها من خير الأمم فقال كنتم خير سبحانه وتعالى كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا صاحبة له ولا والد له ولا ولد له شهادة عليها نحيا وعليها نموت وعليها نبعث إن شاء الله ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله أرسله الله هاديا وبشيرا فاللهم إنا نشهدك أن نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين صلاة ترفعنا بها أعلى الدرجات وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة ومن بعد الممات اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين حق قدره ومقداره العظيم وأما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we bear witness that there is no God but Allah and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. Allah sent him to an ummah that was drowning in the darkness of jahiliyyah, of ignorance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him with a book of guidance and light and guided this ummah from the darkness of jahiliyyah to the lights of faith. And made them خير أمة أخرجت للناس, the best ummah that was raised for the benefit of others. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his prayers and salutations of praise and blessings and mercy to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to his family and to his companions and to their followers till the day of judgment and with us, with them inshaAllah. My dear brothers and sisters, I advise myself and you with me to have taqwa, to be mindful, to be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَرَأْسُ الْحِكْمَةِ مَخَافَةُ اللَّهِ The head and beginning of wisdom is fear of God, is the fear of God. As for what follows, if you were here last Friday, you know by now that the topic was creating a culture of listening within our Muslim communities. And hopefully, inshallah, carrying this culture of listening to the outside communities as well. So that we become beacons of hope. We become carriers of light in the midst of darkness and confusion that we witness in the world. As Muslims, Allah described us, as I said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ You are the best ummah that was raised. لِلنَّاسِ For the benefit of others, the khayriya, our, you know, the description of being the best ummah, the best community here, is not tashrif, is not to honor us, is not a tag that we put as a, you know, or a medal of honor that we walk around and, you know, shame other communities and say, you know, we are better than you, and that's what is said in the Quran. No, it's takleef, it's giving us a responsibility. If we are the best community, By the description of God, this means that we have a job to do, a responsibility to fulfill in order for us to deserve this description of being خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ للناس للناس. And therefore, we should be, when people are losing the most basic principles of human communication, listening and speaking well, قولوا للناس حسنا, speak well to the people, we should be, you know, the reinforcing and reintroducing these human, you know, and common sense characteristics and principles. Just like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to the Arabs at a time when they were going, you know, downhill, and they, at a time when they were losing their most basic characteristics of generosity, of caring for the weak, of speaking the truth, of justice, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to revive all of these morals and virtues and ethics and principles in the Jahili community. And what we witness now is that the communities we live in, whether, you know, here or anywhere around the world, are also, you know, resembling these Jahili communities that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to save and to revive humanity in their midst. And as Muslims, we should be carrying the torch of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam handed down to us, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam handed to us. So last Friday was about starting with one thing, creating a very simple culture that can make a huge change. The culture of listening to one another, be respectful to one another, whether it's parents at home listening to their kids or kids listening to their parents, whether it's spouses listening to one another and showing their kids through example how they can, you know, respect people, other people outside of the house, whether Muslims in their communities, whether it's Muslims in their workplaces, whether it's Muslims in social gatherings, we become an example to be followed on the virtue of listening to one another. And we have examined how this was a divine character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir, He is the Sami'a, the one who listens, the one who hears all voices, and his hearing encompasses all of the voices. As Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, said, Alhamdulillah alladhi wasi'a sam'uhu al-aswat kullaha. Praise be to Allah whose hearing has encompassed all the aswat, all the voices and the sounds and the noises in the world. As a response to this incident where the woman come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complaining and disputing regarding her husband's ill treatment to her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to this woman's words, you know. And then we saw also that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have followed in these divine characteristics and was the best of all. كَانَ أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ اسْتِمَاعًا لِلنَّاسِ. He was the best of all the people listening to other people, giving them his full attention. And the companions from after him, as we have seen Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, giving an example to the tabi'een and to everyone else to be a good listener. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not only listen to Muslims or people who agreed with him. He also listened to people who were considered enemies to him, who were, their best interest was to harm the Prophet and to harm the message of Islam and the community of Muslims. In a hadith that is long, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was approached by Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, وكان سيدا حليما قال ذات يوم وهو جالس في نادي قريش ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جالس وحده في المسجد يا معشر قريش ألا أقوم إلى هذا فأكلمه فأعرض عليه أمورا لعله أن يقبل منها بعضها ويكف عنا قالوا بلى يا أبا الوليد. He said, as he was sitting with a group of Quraishis who were, you know, considered the elites of Quraysh, and their sole goal was to harm the Prophet and to harm Islam and the message of Islam and make sure that it doesn't go, you know, viral and others won't listen to the Prophet and won't follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They physically would place people in the turuqat, in the pathways and roadways, so that they so that they can distract people who are going to listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In any case, he said to his group, to his elite and his club, you know, I'm going to this man, to this man, you know, disrespecting him, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not even mentioning his name. He said, "Ala a'ridu li hadha," I go to this man and tell him, you know, that he needs to stop, you know, inviting people to this message, that he's harming our economy, he's harming our societies, etc. And then he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. حتى جلس إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He went and he sat in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فذكر الحديث فيما قال له عتبة وفيما عرض عليه من المال والملك وغير ذلك. فلما فرغ عتبة قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: أفرغت يا أبا الوليد؟ قال: نعم. قال: فاسمع مني. قال:
The Prophet, the point of the hadith, it's a quite lengthy hadith, but the point is this man went to the Prophet, sat down in his presence and kept talking about how he needs to starve, that we will offer you money, that we will offer you a position, that we will offer you this and that for one condition, and that is that you stop spreading the message of Islam. And what does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do? Does he cover his ears? Does he leave the majlis? Does he leave the sitting and go somewhere else? Does he kick him out? Does he disrespect him or tell him, you know nothing, or you are a disrespectful person? You know what the Prophet ﷺ says to him? A word that we miss hearing in our days. A word that I wish and I hope, inshallah, that our children will hear from our parents, from their parents. A word that I hope that our spouses will hear from one another. A word that I hope that you will tell and say to others who are talking and speaking to you, even if it's a light chatting after the prayers. قال أفرغت يا أبا الوليد. He said, are you done talking? Are you done speaking? Have you said everything you want to say? After all of that, he's telling him to stop preaching, to stop inviting people to Islam, to stop, saying that he is receiving revelation. Stop all of that, we'll give you money. And what does the Prophet say? He said, are you done or do you want to say more? Because if you have more to say, I will listen to you. Because then who was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who was a man who would listen to anyone who would come to him to and ask and require his attention. قال أفرغت؟ قال بلى. قال فاسمع مني. And then he said, now listen to me. Now listen to me. See how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is having this conversation. A beautiful man, beautiful etiquette, beautiful manners that are from the divine description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir. Allah is the one who listens all the voices, and Allah who sees everything. And therefore, Ahad al-Salihin, one of the pious men and righteous men of Islam, said, قَالَ لِجَلِيسِ عَلَيَّ ثَلَاثُ خِصَالٍ, that the one who is sitting in my presence has three rights, from me to him. They have three rights. قَالَ إِذَا أَقْبَلَ وَسَّعْتَ لَهُ الْمَجْلِسِ. Something so beautiful, something so simple, something from the essence that shows and reflects a belief in God. A belief in God, that's not something that you do because you are afraid of Allah, you're afraid that you will be ashamed, people will speak ill of you. No, this is something that you do because you believe in God. He said, إِذَا أَقْبَلَ وَسَّعْتَ لَهُ الْمَجْلِسِ. If they come and sit in my presence, I وَسَّعْتَ لَهُ الْمَجْلِسِ, meaning I will scoot over, or I will give them space. I will give them space to sit in. وَإِذَا جَلَسَ أَقْبَلْتَ عَلَيْهِ. When they sit, I look at them. I show them respect. وَإِذَا حَدَّثَ سَمِعْتَ مِنْهُ. When they speak, I listen to them. These are the characteristics of the righteous men and women of our religion, of our men and religion brothers and sisters. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. O men, O believing men and women, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger invite you to that which لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ, to that which gives you life. Because without any of these things, we become almost like dead, like dead people. We have no soul. We have no meaning to our lives if we just become people who walk around and about their lives eating and drinking. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, إِذَا سَمِعْتَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. If you hear in the Qur'an being recited and you hear the word يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَاسْتَمِعْ لِقَوْلِهِ, then listen, truly listen, لِقَوْلِهِ فَإِنَّهُ خَيْرٌ يُؤْمَرُ بِهِ. It is either something good being commanded, أَوْ شَرٌ يُنْهَى عَنْهُ, أَوْ شَرٌ يُنْهَى عَنْهُ, or something evil that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits. Something evil Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects us from, inshallah. And now, let us move to a different level, brothers and sisters, beyond just listening, or with listening as well, that together, collectively, with the culture of hope that I spoke of previously, and now the culture of listening, let us add one more stone to this beautiful to this beautiful structure Allah Ta'ala protects us from, inshallah. And now, let us move to a different level, brothers and sisters, beyond just listening, or with listening as well, that together, collectively, with the culture of hope that I spoke of previously, and now the culture of listening, let us add one more stone to this beautiful structure of Islam in our hearts, in our communities and homes. And that is the culture of orderliness. To being a community and individuals, households, people that invite to orderliness in our ibadat and in our akhlaq and even in our ideas and thoughts, even in the way we speak. When I stand here and I have not prepared the khutbah well and my ideas are not in order, you will know, because I will be going left and right and, you know, putting things together that don't add up. You will know, because orderliness creates beauty, and the opposite of orderliness creates ugliness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ اللَّيْلُ نَسْلَخُ مِنْهُ النَّهَارُ فَإِذَا هُمْ مُظْلِمُونَ. And Allah continues until he says, لَشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَن تُدْرِكَ الْقَمَرَ وَلَا اللَّيْلُ سَابِقُ النَّهَارُ وَكُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the sun, you know, the sun does not, you know, go into or rise in a time that is not ordered for it, is not calculated for it. And the moon doesn't rise in a time that is not calculated for it. And every and each of these creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is put together or in a divine order that has been calculated carefully to the smallest of the details by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the creation of God, there is order. Sun'a Allah. This is the creation and the work of God, of Allah, who perfected everything He created. When you reflect on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you find that it's orderly. Imagine one day when the sun does not rise up on its time. Imagine one day when the moon does not go in its own cycle. Imagine the confusion and the destruction that they may happen in the world. Allah doesn't create this order for us to just look at it or to even disregard it or even ignore it. Allah wants us to reflect on that and manifest it in our actions. After saying Subhanallah alladhi ahsana kulla shay'in khalaqa, you say Subhanallah, praise to Allah, glory be to Allah, the one who have created everything in accordance to beauty and orderliness. Alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawatin tibaqan. مَا تَرَى فِي خَلْقِ الرَّحْمَنِ مِنْ تَفَاوْتِ. You don't see any inconsistency, disorder in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِهِ صَفًّا كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in the times of fighting, when fear is, you know, the factor that is dominating, when chaos may erupt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even in these moments of fighting, you need to still fight in an orderly manner. Inna Allah yuhibbu alladhina yuqatiluna fi sabilihi saffa, these standing lines, ka'annahum bunyanun marsus, as if they were, you know, stones or bricks building a sound structure that stands on its foundation, that stands the elements of weather, of winds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands people even in times of fighting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَإِذَا كُنْتَ فِيهِمْ فَأَقَمْتَ لَهُمُ الصَّلَاةِ فَلْتَقُمْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ مَعَكَ فَلْيُصَلُّوا وَلْيَأْخُذُوا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ فَإِذَا سَجَدُوا فَلْيَكُونُوا مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ. Allah, even in times also, again in times of praying, Allah wants us to see, Allah wants us to order our lines of prayers. Not a chaotic situation where everyone is facing the direction they like, or lining up or behind. The Prophet used to look back at his, you know, at the Muslims at times of fighting with a stick, and he would make sure that everyone is standing in perfect lines. Why? Because he's putting and instilling inside of them the value of being orderly people. So that when they leave the time of prayers, when they go back to their homes, it's not a chaotic, you know, culture or communities. And the ahadith that speaks about the importance of order are plenty. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna ma ju'ila al-imamu yu'tamma bihi." In a hadith that is quite lengthy, and at the end he says, "Fa'inna wa aqimu as-saffa fi as-salati fa'inna iqamata as-saffi min husni as-salah." That you need to straighten your lines. Wa aqimu as-saffa fi as-salah. Straighten your lines. Make them orderly. فَإِنَّ إِقَامَةَ الصَّفِّ مِنْ تَمَامِ الصَّلَاةِ For the straightness of the lines, مِنْ تَمَامِ الصَّلَاةِ Completes your prayers, which means without it, your prayers is not complete. Without order, your most important action that you will be, you know, judged for, that you will be asked for on the day of judgment, the first thing you will be asked for is prayers. Without order in your prayers, it's not complete. It's broken. It's not complete. So if the order in the most important action. Imagine now the most basic thing that one can do, parking your car in a parking lot. Imagine if Allah wants us to have order in the most important action that should straighten up your entire life to the most easiest, hopefully easiest. It doesn't seem like it is. Unfortunately, every Friday we have to struggle. And people have to struggle leaving the place and parking in the parking lot. Why? Because there's an absence of the culture of orderliness. If you look behind you and you see how sometimes our shoe rack is a mess, that reflects that our prayers, we perform them like robots. We don't think. If you go any place around the world, one thing you will hear from the imam before the prayers, استقيموا, استووا. تراسوا اعتدلوا ساووا الصفوف وسدوا الفرج straighten your lines, stand in orders, سدوا الفرج, close the gaps, shoulder to shoulder, foot to foot. Why are we saying all of that? Is it just to waste time, to sound cool, something that we say without understanding what it means? Why do we not understand that it is an invitation from God, the one who created the sun, the heavens, the stars, the earth, and every single little detail in the world with detail, with order and calculation that is very careful? Why do you think Allah did that? So that we look at it and say, oh, cool, yeah, great. And then we come to the prayers. سَاوُوا صُفُوفَكُمْ فَإِنَّ تَمَامَ فَإِنَّ مُسَاوَةَ الصَّفِّ مِنْ تَمَامِ الصَّلَاةِ Why do we say that? So that it reflects in our character, in our behavior, brothers and sisters. So as soon as we leave this room right here, we can leave and take order and make it a culture of ours. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ لِي وَلَكُمْ أُدْعُوا اللَّهَ أَنْتُمْ مُقِيمُونَ بِالْإِجَابَةِ Pray to the Lord and have faith. The two prayers will be accepted, inshallah. إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَهْدِيهِ وَنَسْتَرْضِيهِ وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Imam al-Bukhari, a book that we consider the most sound book after the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you go to the Kitab al-Adhan, the chapter of al-Adhan, and then you go into Bab, he calls it Bab iqamati as-saffi min tamam as-salah. This is the most sound book after the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this great Imam, he makes a whole chapter on إِقَامَةُ الصَّفِّ مِنْ تَمَامِ الصَّلَاةِ A chapter on straightening the lines in prayers, because this is from the perfection of salah. And not only Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim as well, he says بَابُ تَسْوِيَةِ الصُّفُوفِ وَإِقَامَتَهَا وَفَضْلُ الصَّفِّ الْأَوَّلِ And also Imam Muslim as well has a chapter on straightening the lines in prayers. The point is, brothers and sisters, is that when we straighten our lines in prayers, this is not done for abath. This is not done for, no reason. It's done so that it can reflect in our culture, in our character, in our behaviors, so that when we leave the prayer room, when we go to our homes, when we go to our workplaces, when we park our cars before the prayers, we have to consider other people. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَنْ آذَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ فِي طُرُقِهِمْ وَجَبَتْ عَلَيْهِ لَعْنَتُهُمْ I know this is a strong hadith, and I had to really look really deep and dig deep and hard until I find it. The Prophet said, and I know it's a very strong hadith, but its meaning I will tell you what it means. But man adha al-muslimina fi turuqihim, the one who harms Muslims and people in general, this applies to everyone, not just Muslims. Man adha, the one who harms people in their ways. What fi turuqihim wajabat alayhi la'natuhum. This means, and it means that when someone, let me put it in our just situation so that we don't have a long discussion. When someone doesn't park their cars right, when someone blocks people away, I see a car right now that is parking right in front of the way. If there's a fire, then there is a possibility, because it's getting hot in here. But if there's a fire and there's a fire truck, it won't be able to park, to get into the building and to put the fire down and to save people's life. And that is something that the Prophet ﷺ said. Someone who does this, someone who doesn't park their car right, yes, wajabat alayhi la'natun, he should be admonished. You should find this person and speak to him harshly. And this is not something I'm doing because I don't have a car out there, I don't care. But this is something because the Prophet ﷺ said, order and considering people and considering safety and being, considerate of people and the way they walk in and they drive in is very important. It's part of this religion. So if you come here and you pray 5,500 rak'ah, and then your car is parked out there in a crooked way, you're blocking people's way, you are harming people, there is a big contradiction. You have to think about it in your mind. So this is, brothers and sisters, a very serious matter. And it's been observed many different times, and it's very difficult for me to stand here and to speak to you like this. But it is a huge part of that really pains me and pains many other people, elderly people. Yesterday there were people trying to go to their work last Friday, and there were people trying to go to their work and they weren't able to. And you have harmed them. You have caused them harm. You have caused them harm. There are elders who, I know people who are elders who come here and they're not able to come and pray because we don't have a place to park. It's very difficult for us to park because of all of the chaos that is in the parking lot. So, and it's from the shukru ni'am. This is, Allah has given us a ni'am, a blessing. A beautiful, spacious building and a spacious parking lot. And it's nothing that we can do other to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be grateful for what He gave us other than using it right, doing it right. If you don't know how to park, approach someone and tell them, they can teach you. If you park as far as possible, that's good for you. For every step you're going to take to the masjid, you get a hasanah, you get a one reward. And for every other step, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clears a sin from you. So in fact that you want to park as close as possible and become an inconvenient for other people, that's bad for you on so many different levels. And the other thing I want to share with you is a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man kana lahu fadlu dhahrin," the one who has an extra space in their cars. And I know he didn't say cars, but I'm trying to translate the meaning of the hadith into our modern time. The one who has an extra space in their car and they utilize it by giving someone else a ride, they have a huge reward. They have a huge reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are able to give someone a ride so that we can minimize the number of cars in the parking lot, this is something you will do and you will gain reward. Even if you don't come to prayers on time and receive the reward of becoming early on the day of Friday, you get a reward for giving someone a ride. So consider this. If you have a